In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to place a large bore rapid infusion IV catheter, followed by a brief discussion of the common pitfalls of the procedure. Aero rapid infusion catheters, or RIC lines, are a product line of very large bore peripheral intravenous catheters designed to be placed easily and rapidly in trauma or other large volume hemorrhage situations. The Aero product line offers two catheter sizes, a 7 French and 8.5 French catheter. Since both catheters can handle a Belmont rapid infusion device at full flow, the 7 French catheter is appropriate for most situations. RIC lines are the largest peripheral IV catheters available on the market. Here, you can see that RIC lines dwarf even a massive 14-gauge IV catheter. Opening the package for this 7 French RIC kit, we see it contains three items. A RIC line with integrated dilator, a guide wire in plastic sheath, and a small scalpel. The 8.5 French RIC kit contains the same items except the hub of the 8.5 French catheter is blue in color. In addition to the items in the RIC kit, you will need a tourniquet, skin antiseptic, 20-gauge IV catheter, and IV infusion tubing. Here, my colleague Dr. Alzara will demonstrate proper RIC line placement. First, place a tourniquet on the arm and select a large vein. Clean with antiseptic. Place a 20-gauge intravenous catheter by whatever technique you prefer. After successful IV placement, insert the guide wire. Remove 20-gauge catheter. With a scalpel, make a small, superficial 2 to 3 millimeter skin nick along the wire. Feed the combined catheter and dilator over the wire, ensuring that the wire exits the catheter hub at the top. Pull the skin taut and insert the dilator into the skin and advance until the catheter is cleanly in the vessel. Slide the catheter off the dilator the rest of the way into the vessel. Remove the dilator and wire. Attach IV tubing, stitch the catheter in if desired, and cover with a dressing. You do not need to place a new 20-gauge IV catheter for RIC line placement. Using an existing 20-gauge IV that's been wasted in a large antecubital vein is the perfect scenario to upsize that IV to a RIC line. Simply take down the dressing, remove the IV tubing, and place the guide wire. If you have a choice in 20-gauge IV catheters, try to avoid bloodless style catheters. The diaphragm that prevents blood backflow may also catch the guide wire in the hub, complicating guide wire threading. In this video, we demonstrated an appropriate level of cleanliness for a hemorrhaging patient. But when the RIC line is being placed for an elective case, the process can be performed with full Sterotechnique for additional cleanliness. If the patient is conscious, anesthetize the skin with local anesthetic. Remember that this is not a central line. Be mindful to make a superficial skin nick, not a deep nick, that may injure the vein. Despite their large bore, you may get little to no bleed back from these catheters, especially in hypovolemic patients. And finally, be absolutely sure to remove the dilator before using the catheter. The dilator has a lure lock connector and will flow fairly well if connected to IV tubing. If left in place, the stiff dilator can cause significant damage to the vein. This concludes our discussion of RIC line placement. Thanks for watching.